بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم and welcome to Spirit of Islam. I'm your host Ashraf Zaglul and today inshallah in our show we will carry on our discussion about the Pope's quoting the Byzantine Emperor that what did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bring new. We got diverted last time and we start discussing how could we as a Muslim community contribute to this wonderful society we live in. But inshallah today I want us to focus on this and discuss what has Islam brought to us. I'd like to introduce our panel today, Saeedul Islam, Huma Chaudhry, Nahla Rashad, and Humtan Yarkhan. Assalamu alaikum. So I'd like to start with you, Humtan, and get your feedback. You had some comments about last show.
Well, last week I was watching the show and I noticed the theme of the show was that in order to get a positive image of Islam out there, yes, we have to lead by example.
Yes.
And I agree with that point 100%.
Mm-hmm.
But as an objective viewer, if I was a non-Muslim watching it, I would say, well, you know, the Christians do good things, the Jews do good things. So what puts Muslims in a different category? So when I was thinking, when I was watching the show, I was thinking, well, as Muslims, our job to avoid people like making the comments like the Pope did is to show a connection between what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, taught us and what good conduct we're doing.
Yes.
Like to find a saying or example of the Prophet, peace be upon him, in a certain situation and then carry out that example in the present day today so we can show the people why comments made by the Pope are so preposterous to us Muslims because we know what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is like. And if other people got to know the truth about him and how he really was, then they would see themselves that the comments the Pope made was completely false and out of question.
Well, you know, out of fairness, the Pope was quoting the Byzantine Emperor. And maybe, you know, my feeling is the Pope should have qualified it as, say, his own opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Because in a way, when you quote somebody and you don't mention whether you support or not, people by default will take it, you are supporting this.
True.
You are supporting your argument by it. So this is one of the points where I felt the Pope should have qualified it. But, you know, as a non-Muslim, and I was on a show a couple of weeks ago, a different show, and somebody asked the question, what did Islam bring that's new? And what did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bring that is new or different? And maybe, you know, I would like your personal opinion, each one of you, come back and tell me, what's your personal, what do you think was different? Let's start with you, Muhammad.
Well, I think to really understand what Islam brought that was new, I think when we need to study the history and see the situation of the world at the time when the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, came.
Yes.
How the people were, what their customs were, and such a dramatic change that the whole society made in the span of 23 years of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon his life. For example, one example I can think of is Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, who was the second caliph, who was a very leading figure in Islamic history after he became Muslim. That when he was describing himself before the Prophet, peace be upon him, came, he was talking about a custom of the Arabs at that time, which was to bury your firstborn daughters.
Yeah.
And he recalls when he was burying his daughter and his beard was covered with the dust and his daughter was wiping off the dust and he was still burying her. So he was saying, at that time, my ignorance was so bad that I didn't see this as something to bring compassion to my heart. I still buried her.
Yes.
And now that I'm Muslim, now I'm seeing what the harm of the actions I did before I became Muslim. So to really understand what Islam brought, you have to see what the position was of the people before and what it was after.
Yes, in a way, but you know, other people of other faiths will tell you, well, that's what other religions brought, you know. So yes, we agree there was a big difference in Arabia between before Islam and after Islam. But the argument that's made by other faiths is, but that's the same message that was brought before by Moses, by Jesus, and other prophets. And this is the thing we really need to look at. Is it's Islam, in my mind, Islam did not just bring a religion. It's a religion that could applied in everyday life. Actually, you know, the wonderful thing I love about Islam, if you look at things, you will find that in our religion, there's precedence, as they call it in the legal thing, is there precedence? If you have a question, or what should I do in Islam, you will find there's precedence in Islam to tell you, to guide you. It's a guidance. So it gave us a way of life. Islam is not just worshipping Allah, but it is a way of life. And that's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّمَا الدِّينُ الْمُعَامَلَةِ. It's treatment, how we treat each other, how we deal with each other.
Tolerance.
Yes.
Tolerance is the big part.
Mm-hmm.
The tolerance is the big part.
But how do we teach people this? How do we tell Muslims? See, I've always said that Islam is misunderstood, and mostly by Muslims. Because how they relate to non-Muslims, how, you know, we're not giving the true message of Islam or how Islam was. But, you know, let's try, Nahla, in your mind, what do you feel Islam has brought us?
I just want to, I'm going to answer to that question, but there was a point that you brought before, is that how do we tell people, you know, Islam is different and so forth. And I do agree that Islam... you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought the Moses with a message, Jesus with a message, and Muhammad with a message, but it's the same in the heart of it all.
Yes.
But people tend to forget between so and so with their culture and habits and all this stuff. And with Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, the message is very clear because of the Quran and how it it shows us the way, as you're indicating, you know, of life.
Yes.
And it doesn't matter which day or age you're going to live that life.
Yes.
The one thing that I fear so much these days are the cultures that I've really, as a Muslim coming from Egypt at the age of 18, living here for so many years, I've seen truly the difference between a culture and religion.
Yes.
And unfortunately, a lot of our a lot of us as families, we live by culture most of the time, not by religion, not by the way of Islam. And that's, there is something here to be said on how we should really differentiate the culture and how we should deal with each other on the culture part of things, and how we can take the teaching of Islam in our society and spread that teaching of Islam.
Actually, I would
and
go
I get
as,
scared about that
you
part.
Know, I would go as far as I say, a lot of Muslims look at culture things and they think it is Islam. And we intermix culture with Islam. And the story I shared with everybody before, you know, I never used to like ketchup. And my daughter, she, you know, she's born here, she grew up here, she loves ketchup. And when she sees somebody offering me to eat ketchup, she says, my dad is a Muslim, he doesn't eat ketchup. But that's what she could relate, that what's different, my dad is a Muslim. So here, she took a culture issue where maybe when I grew up there was no ketchup, huh? And it wasn't as available, and she related it to Islam, which has nothing to do. But a lot of us, honestly, if you analyze our life, you will find that we have a lot of cultural issues that we, growing up in a Muslim society, or we think it's, you know, we've related this is to Islam. And I think this is a lot of the issues. Islam, maybe you can reflect on some of this and tell us what's your thought.
Yeah.